I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Now, this lesson is all about descending fingerpicked phrases on acoustic guitar. Now, the descending phrase is something that a lot of songs have used to create beautiful acoustic guitar arrangements. So in this lesson, we're going to focus on using the key of G to learn a method that creates descending lines using a three-part approach. We'll start off with a primary idea, and then I've added a couple of turnarounds to take the phrasing back into the primary section once again. After that, we're going to do an ending, and I've included a final part that's really nice. It focuses on making a minor resolution. All in all, it's going to be a fantastic lesson, but first, before we get started, I do have a quick word I want to share with you about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. To help you fully understand the technique of playing and composing descending acoustic guitar fingerpicked phrases, my lesson is going to break the approach down for you into three parts. Each part is easy enough to play that it'll only take you about a minute or so to learn and memorize each one. Plus, the chords for each part are all common open chords, most of which I'll bet you've already seen and played before, especially if you're at the intermediate guitar playing level. So let's get started with part one. It involves learning our primary phrase. After that, we will learn a couple of turnarounds, and then I'll wrap up the lesson with a final ending that focuses on a resolution into minor tonality. So our first part sounds like this. Let me play that again and just describe what's going on. We're going across this G major 6 chord with a G, B, a duplicate of the B, and then an E note, which is our 6th interval, up on top as an open 1st string. Then we're going to do an E minor chord pretty much, but the only difference is we're adding an F sharp into the base of it. After that, we're going to go into a full-on E minor. We're going to cover it in 5th position from the 7th fret 5th string, going across those open strings as well of the 3rd and 2nd. Plus on top there, we're going to do a little guitar lick just to kind of like, you know, back it up and give it a bit more energy at the end. Here's all the parts put together nice and slow for you. All right, so that is the primary phrase. The next thing I want to do with you is just show you a couple of secondary phrases that you can practice. These secondary phrases are going to be pretty cool because you're going to have an option with them of whichever one that you like better to be able to insert it and use it as your favorite. So here's the first phrase. It's going to start off on this C add 2 chord, then go through B minor 7, and then a D chord with F sharp in the bass. So that's a really rich sound, especially having that inversion with the F sharp down there. Sounds really nice. All right, so that's turnaround phrase number one off of that C add 2 chord. We're going to use that C add 2 chord again in the second phrase, but where it's going to change up is in the second measure. So here is the second turnaround phrase. It goes like this. So we do have another inversion of the D chord there, and that's happening in that second measure as having a D chord, but it has the G note down in the bass now. Now, if you're kind of wondering, well, what in the world does a G note have to do with a D chord? It's kind of like using a suspended on that G, having it come in there, and then removing it. You can hear the G comes in, and it's like a suspended 4th, and then that 3rd comes back. Now, we're doing that in a sense, but we're just not bringing it out of that G to the F sharp. We're just leaving the G down in the bass. And it really gives a nice dreamy sound off of this second turnaround. Let me play you this second turnaround one more time. Now, just before that D with G in the bass, I am playing through an A minor chord. So that's kind of different, a little bit different sound. We're gonna come back to that idea though, because next thing I need to do is show you this ending, and I'm gonna show you the ending next. So let me just play it down through for you so you know what it sounds like first. It goes like this. So we're starting off there on the C add 2 again, just going right across it. Then we're moving into the A minor. Remember I said we're gonna bring that A minor back in again. That A minor is giving us a little bit of minor color because at the end we're gonna bring it around to an E minor. Just before that though, we're gonna play a G chord that has an A note in it. So we're gonna call that one the G add 2. The 2 is the A coming in there. And then of course the wrap up takes us around into an E minor color. So if you're familiar with something, you know, to do with relative keys, this is really what we're doing here. We're in the key of G, but we're going to be focusing at the end there into an E minor. And a lot of the push and the phrasing that we have in this particular piece really does point a little bit more in that direction of E minor overall. Now, what I did here at the end is I do have a jam loop that I'm going to fire up right away. And you can get the jam loop if you're a Patreon member of mine. All you got to do is go over to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. This lesson release is going to be on a Wednesday, so you will need the Knowledge and Wisdom platform to be able to access both the PDF handout that gives you all the details of this lesson, as well as this jam loop. Now, I'm going to fire up the jam loop. I'm going to play my rendition of how I fit together all these parts so you can hear what it sounds like when it comes together as a piece. So, here we go. So as you can tell, you put all the parts together in whatever way and order and sequence that you prefer, and you can come up with a really nice idea based out of it. One last thing I need to mention is pay particular attention to how these notes are dropping down, because it is a descending phrase. You could also, if you wanted to, create phrases of your own that ascend. Maybe I'll do another lesson on ascending. If you want me to do that, make sure you leave some comments in the comment section below and let me know that you want me to fulfill that end of things for you. But otherwise, guys, again, if you want to get the handout, meet me next over at Patreon. It's patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. I've been doing a lot of Patreon lessons for a long time, and I believe we're heading up to 500 lessons over on Patreon now, and it's really cheap to be able to sign up over there. If you have any questions, you can ask me them through the Patreon community chat. And otherwise, aside from the stuff that I put up on a regular basis, I do have a Thursday Hang that's a special publication over there for you as well. Check it all out at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And hey guys, if you need extra chops building, if you need to understand the neck more, learn things like advanced chords, all the advanced theory, arpeggios, all the scales, all the ideas on improvisation, and all the details to do with playing instruments like the acoustic guitar, all that stuff, go over to my actual website. It's my website. It has nothing to do with Patreon, so they're totally independent of one another. They're not associated in any way. My website is creativeguitarstudio.com. Over there, you can sign up for a membership to take my core curriculum, which is my beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar program. Highly, highly structured stuff, step by step, chapter by chapter. There's nothing else like it on the internet. Go and check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. Along with those core curriculum courses, though, I also have a bunch of electives. You could study acoustic guitar. I've got guitar soloing, guitar technique, a songs program, rhythm guitar, ear training. There's a ton of stuff. You're going to love it. Go and check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. Also, remember, for the handout and the MP3 jam track for this lesson, everything's available over on Patreon at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Learning to play beautiful acoustic guitar lines like this will help get you one step closer to becoming the best guitar player that you can be. To learn more, sign up for a free membership today at creativeguitarstudio.com. With a free membership, you'll be able to access all the free lesson material, including a collection of 6 years of YouTube archives, where there are hundreds of videos, PDF handouts, and MP3 jam tracks. Plus, with a free membership, you'll gain access to the Quick Licks program, a 30-lesson course covering guitar licks in all playing styles across all types of scales and arpeggios. When you sign up for a paid membership, you'll get access to my core curriculum, including my beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs. Plus, there's also my elective courses on the site, like acoustic guitar, guitar technique, guitar soloing, ear training, music reading, and many others. Go check it out. You're going to love it. The website is creativeguitarstudio.com. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.